Nothing is macking harder than this smoked Gouda lobster and andouille sausage mac and cheese right here. For the sake of time, I've already preheated my skillet so that we can go ahead and get our andouille sausage sliced up. We're going to saute them separately along with the lobster. All right, now you know it all starts with the butter. So I'm gonna take this andouille sausage here. It's going right in. We're gonna get that sauteed up. We get that tossed together, get a little butter coated over, and now we're gonna go into our lobster tails, baby. I'm gonna slice these lobster tails up.
Before I was vegan, I did love a good lobster mac.
Oh, man, and trust me, if you tasted this one, you still would love a good one. Now that we got that lobster all sliced and diced up, we're gonna incorporate it right in with that andouille sausage. You have all those amazing flavors just coming together. The good mac and cheese, guys, start with the root. Already got that butter melted down, and see, we're gonna just fold in that flour. I've cooked this to the right amount of time. Okay. If you can pass me those creams, we're gonna add in that smoked cheddar in here.
Oh, wow.
We have our Gruyere cheese that we're getting in.
That's actually gorgeous.
We're gonna add in the remaining cream here.
That is a thick cheese sauce.
Yes, hey.
Wow.
If it ain't tight, it ain't right.
Wow.
We're gonna add in the smoked paprika, and I add in some already ground nutmeg, but I like adding notes of fresh nutmeg to it.
Yeah.
Now, what I'm gonna do, you know, that andouille sausage and that lobster, I want it with
all the juices.
Yes.
Yeah.
All the juices going in. So we want it all just to blend in. Yeah, check out that, see? That's what you
wow.
want right there. You thought you came to play, but didn't realize you came to stay. That's what we're going for
that
right
there. That is
gooey. This is what we want. Now you just follow those in. You don't want no running mac and cheese.
No.
You're supposed to be the mac.
Like,
you don't need to be
running nowhere.
Where you
going, mac and cheese? Why
exactly.
you running?
Now would you mind passing me that salt and pepper?
Got you.
Yes, yes. Now, what I also like to do, a little cool little cheat, whenever I'm building out my mac and cheeses in their own individual bowls for the kids, I like to go ahead and pre-oil the bottom of them. It's time to scoop that mac and cheese. I know, that's what I go for.
I love these bowls, too.
That's
a nice
wow
touch.
Fact. That's what you want in your life. All right, now set the oven to 325. We're gonna pop these bad boys in for 15 minutes.
Help you out.
And the cool thing about this, guys, is, well, normally, you know, you bake mac and cheese for a longer period of time, but I've actually cooked everything already ahead of time. So on 325 for 15 minutes, it's just loosening that cheese up and making sure all those ingredients mold together, and you really get to experience the flavors as a whole.
Now this is the moment that you've been waiting for.
Well, you've been waiting for.
I know you've been so excited, so I'm gonna grab my
okay.
ultimate vegan mac and cheese.
All right.
I love a crispy top. Now I'm like a corner and edges girl.
Okay.
What you got?
Let's go over here and show you how. The real Max do it.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, look at this right here.
Oh, wow.
Yes. Oh, my goodness.
Well, I love a good
closing
messy.
Closing that oven for me, Portia? Now, this is what you want right here. Now, one of the things when you remove these out of the oven, you know your little ramekins are gonna be hot. So, you wanna go ahead and remove them from your sheet pan, because the sheet pan holds a lot of heat as well. And just let them sit on a nice, good chopping board.
It's like still cooking in front of my eyes right now.
When these go table side and you seeing that bubbling.
You guys still hear the sizzle.
That's what you want, exactly.
That one is still spilling.
Yes, I know, right?
So
remember you said you was a corner edges, girl. I got it right here for you.
This whole thing is edging corner.
Yes, it is.
That's
you believe
what you get when you make it like a small dish like that. That's amazing.
Yes. Let me show you a little something right here. That's what you want right there.
That's very creamy.
See how nice and toasted that top is?
But also the cream, like the cheese, it did loosen
up. And then also remember how we oiled the sides. So see, nothing is sticking. Let me just go ahead and get a little bit of this since I'm playing with it here.
Oh. It smells great.
Mm. And it tastes so good. And there you have it, my smoked Gouda lobster and andouille sausage mac and cheese right there.